What's up, guys? It is Will here, back again, and we're here to talk about something very exciting, for some people anyway. Clone Commander Fox from Hot Toys for Star Wars May the 4th. Let's read the description real quick. Commander Fox led the Coruscant Guard, trademark Coruscant Guard, an elite clone trooper unit assigned to serve as peacekeepers of the Galactic Republic, also trademark. Like every other clone trooper in the Guard, Fox was bound by honor and duty to protect and serve the Supreme Chancellor and the members of the Galactic Senate. Celebrating the 20th anniversary of Star Wars The Clone Wars animation, Hot Toys is pleased to expand its collectible series and present the 1/6 scale figure of the clone Commander Fox. The highly detailed collectible figure is specially crafted based on the performance of Commander Fox in his Phase 1 armor. So, all right. I know very little about Clone Wars. I have very, very sparsely watched it. I watched like maybe half of the first season. I didn't really love it that much, so I stopped watching it. I do hear it gets better. However, I have not dove back into that pool. That said, I do like the color scheme on this trooper. It's very maroon. It has a nice contrast between the white and the maroon parts. I love the long blaster rifle. I think that's pretty cool. I'm sure it has a better name than that. The short one also gives you a lot of options for posing if you want to do that. There's also some blasters that are shorter in the holster here that you can tell. Short, little more pistol-like blasters. I do think this is a cool-looking trooper. However, all the troopers are starting to blend together to me at this point. I can barely tell the difference between them. I do like the ones that have more characterization to them, like Cody or Rex characters and figures like that, because they actually a lot of times have an arc or some sort of character development compared to a nameless trooper. That said, I do like the color scheme on this one. I do think this would pop pretty cool on a shelf. But would I get it? Absolutely not. For me, I'm just not a Clone Wars fan. But for those out there who do love Clone Wars, I could see people picking these up. Because, look, people love their troopers. As much as sometimes we crap on troopers, Hot Toys knows that they can make these, that they will sell, that they are pretty inexpensive to make, clearly. And then many people will buy multiple of them. This is a character that has characterization, though, so buying multiple might not be as practical as buying just a nameless trooper multiple. But you know, some people will do it. And I do feel like with troopers, people really, really like displaying them, because when you put a lot of them together, it does make a display come alive. That said, they're not for me. I have Praetorian Guards. I think they're the only troopers I have at the moment. So really, this is not one for me, truly. But again, if I'm looking at the artistry of the figure, I do feel like it's pretty cool. I like the weathering. I like the contrast between the maroon, brown, and the red. The detailing on the chest has a very... It's weird, it has a very Iron Man look to it, does it not? Like with the circle, it looks like an arc reactor or something, but it doesn't light up, it's painted on, but you know, you get the idea there. So yeah, I do think there's a lot of options with the weapons too. As a person not a huge fan of the Clone Wars, I was hoping a little bit more from May the 4th. I do hope we get more than this, because if this is it, I think a lot of us are going to be pretty disappointed. I was expecting a bigger showcase. So we'll see throughout the morning, we'll monitor throughout the day and even into tomorrow. But overall, I'm interested to see the prices on these for the U.S. I got to look at the Hong Kong prices for these at Secret Base. But I will say, I wouldn't expect them to be too crazy. I think this Clone Commander Trooper, he doesn't even have a head sculpt. So I think you're probably looking at like the 250, 265 range, something like that. For Palpatine, Darth Sidious, you're probably looking at something like 300 or something. That would be my best guess. So for U.S. prices. So anyway, guys, let me know what you think in the comments below. I do like this long blaster rifle. I do think that's pretty cool. I think you could do a lot with that, and it just has more presence to it. But this is a very colorful boy here with a very cool design. So I think that's more to me what he has going for him. But the character development might be important to some people. This might be a very treasured character to some for the fans of the Clone Wars. So let me know, guys, in the comments below whether you think this is going to be a pickup for you. For me, it's a pass, but interested to see everyone's thoughts on this to gauge sort of community reaction. That said, guys, thank you so much. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Peace out. Bye. See you later. Bye.